All right, hello everybody, and welcome to Dark Souls Guide, I believe part 7, yes. So if you guys hear me sniffling and all that, I have my allergies acting up today, so please excuse my rustiness. So yeah, so you might remember this part from the last episode. This is the catacombs. I'm going to continue off and show you where all the items and then the final boss of this area. Now, the first area we're going to go is here because it's easiest. So you jump down, kill whatever comes after you. Okay, so I remember we just killed the necromancer. Now, you might see this as, holy moly, dead drop. Actually isn't. Okay, you want so if you roll, you want to aim towards here. Because if you aim for that lump, like as you saw, it would slide you and might make you fall. So, yeah, let's just... Oh, look at that, a green titanite shard. Okay. So, now you just want to jump down and jump down. Yeah, if you aim for the hole, you actually take no damage. Again, it's also really hard to aim there. Very staticky, and yeah, so that's the fire blacksmith and chaos blacksmith. He imbues your weapons in flame. Actually, what I want to do with this claymore, but yeah, so or a different weapon. Nah, I'll do the claymore, but yeah, so this is the blacksmith. You can modify the equipment to a fire claymore. I would actually wait till it's plus 10, then make a fire claymore. So I'm not really gonna do here. But yeah, so yeah, so you can purchase the titanite shards and all that from him. You can give him the chaos ember to him. So he doesn't really like to chit-chat. So yeah, so if you're wondering, there's nothing back here. Just the area you dropped from, and now you have to go from here. Now, you would naturally head that way for the boss. Ouch. I just forgot about this area. Alright. And I died. Oh well. This happens. So, hey. Anyways, I'm gonna re-show you that area a bit. And this time I'm just gonna try and aim for the, hole. So yeah, so part of my death, I totally zoned out. Again, these allergies and my head's, it's getting my head all cloggy stuffy right now, so not the best time, but videos have to be pushed out, so you just run it. And bye bye, there they go. And you wanna go, like I said. But right, you can only aim for the hole the first time. Second times you had to be careful. My mistake. Again, it's been a while. I haven't played it. Now I just lost 5,000 souls. That's okay. But yeah, so let me go and do everything again. So, jump down here. Jump here because. So yeah, so now that we're back, hold your block, and now these guys are pricks because they will literally take away your health. Like, I mean, no joke. As you see, they will rip you to shreds. Yeah, so, sorry guys, usually I'm more tankier by now, but again, as I am doing a guide, I don't get to go off and farm too much, because I want to show a pretty evened out guide as you guys would be. You guys can go farm and wait to go do here, but I'm just... For the sake of the guide, I am doing as you would naturally. Ah, boy. So heal up. Yeah, so, yeah, let's... Let's go here, let's attract them, and let's run back. Are they coming? Yep. So once Mac with the claymore heavy, they die. So, keep luring them out. And just keep that up. I think that should be the last one. No, there's one more over here. You can see his shimmering. Yep, you see that? You can see their shimmer of their wheels. Or their blades. Now I believe you're only gonna see these skeletons in one other area. So yeah, so pretty much. Now you wanna get these skeletons to wanna explode and you run away. Pretty much. And then there's a black knight here. There we go. Now he's unglitched. Oh, there's one more pinwheel. Oh no, there's more. Oh boy. Okay, now the Black Knight's here and one more pinwheel. So there's all the pinwheels, not pinwheels, but the wheeling skeletons. Pinwheels the boss. But yeah, so now you want to get enough stamina to be able to block him and then walk around him as much as you can. And then backstab him. That's really the easiest way. You could parry, but I'm not risking that with what I have. See, as you saw, I just thought I could finish him off, but... It turned out... Oh, great. White Titanuck and the Black Knight Great Axe. Yeah, so you would go that way for the boss, but we're not gonna go that way yet. You can go now, but if you want to get all the items here, I do recommend to Alright, so so I'm gonna do this just for a full on heal. I'm gonna use the glitch. I'm gonna put fire on my sword so I can do more damage. And we gotta go up here. So yeah. So that area is a bit of pain in the butt. If you just wanna go fight the boss, then you can just run by them. But these guys, and no item there. Item drop. Can I activate this? So yeah, these are little drop areas, and then you can go. Let's just see. Yeah, so okay, yeah, you want to go into the drop holes because you can get this item, a soul of a proud knight. And yeah, so oh boy. Now there's also one other, besides the part I was gonna show originally, there's another part I remembered. There's a boss, you can encounter a boss before fighting him and joining his covenant. So, I will show how you do this, but that all depends if I can defeat a specific enemy. Yeah, there's this specific enemy.
Oh man, crazy.
Okay, yeah, so you want to do here? Yeah, the problem with this guy is that you're in an enclosed space. And I can barely do any damage.
Oh yeah, after I get down on the path.
Yeah, so best thing is to stay away from his attacks as much as you can, and block as much as you can, and then just go in for the heal as much as you can. Again, I recommend this not to be like me right now. So I'm just gonna back up and take a humanity. Again, I can do this because again, I'm gonna be also using the cheat, so humanity is not a problem for me. So yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna actually have to back up. And go back in there. Again, that's a waste of a fire on my weapon, but so again, this is doable. But again, I recommend having a stronger weapon, hopefully a plus 10. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh boy. Okay, thank you, sir. Oh boy. There we have it. Ow. I'm almost dead. I gotta Run away. Nope, that didn't work. Through there, there's an item, and, I'll just quickly show you guys. I believe there's another way in, as we saw earlier, so I will try and find that entrance. I believe it's through here. Thank you, Skelter, for jumping off. Are you gonna jump off? Please do. Anyway, so we had to go through here. And, oh, guide humanity. And someone who died. Yay. Also, there is an area through here, so we're gonna explore that. Okay, so there is a necromancer somewhere around here. So we gotta quickly find that necromancer. Okay, I think this was through the way, wasn't it? Yep. Oh boy. Oh, nope. This is a different area. Oh boy. We're gonna just keep running around in a circle. I royally screwed myself here. I mean, I am royally screwed. So I need to just run, grab the item, the Dark Moon Ring, yep, heal up, and then keep on running. Ow, that went straight through me. And just go up, I believe either here or the other side, ow. Right in my between my Okay, now first let's just get rid of him, even though that we can't. Yeah, so this is really not the best. Ow, that hurts, that hurts, that hurts, and we're dead. So, yeah, this area is, again, a pain in the butt. I did not find it there. I'm missing a necromancer. Oh. Because those guys kept coming. So, I gotta find that and kill that necromancer. So, yeah. Let's, see. Necromancers up there were killed. So, the only one I can think of... Oops. Did a stupid roll. Okay, guys, please. Again, this is a guide. I'm doing some stupid stuff during this guide. So, the stupid stuff, guys, please don't follow. Just basic stuff. So, yeah. So, watch this video before doing step by step. This is not a step by step guide. I will help people out with a step-by-step in certain areas, but this area is one of my most hated. I am not doing a step-by-step for this area. So again, oh yeah, there is an item here. And the, and we got, trying not to fight these enemies as much. So. Yeah, so pardon me, guys. I'm just, trying to find that last necromancer. Ow, and I'm getting really screwed about it. Okay, let's keep a move on. There's an item here. Oh, there he is. and I'm dead. It's okay. No humanity is there, so yeah. So I'm gonna go kill off that one because I don't know, might be somehow affecting the ones in another area. Don't know how these guys down here actually get killed when that necromancer is there. Really weird. But yeah, so, or you can just go back up through that pathway. I'm gonna kill that necromancer. I thought I killed him. I guess I didn't. Pretty sure I have. But anyways, so yeah. So you just kill that necromancer from up here. And I believe that was it. So I'll go back through the regular pathway. And don't go off there, you'll die. Yeah, so do apologize for that. I'm rusty on this area. If I had a divine weapon, I wouldn't be running around confused. Yeah, so no right necromancers here, so so this should be good. And apparently not. Apparently I am not good. And I am not good for some reason. There's still a necromancer somewhere. I don't know where they are. And I had bleed loss, that's what killed me. This is why I hate this area the most. And I recommend caution. Unlike me, I'm just trying to find out. Like I said, if you made a divine weapon, then this will be area a lot easier because skeletons will not be coming back to life. Sadly, I didn't do that. Yes, very sadly. So I had to literally rush this area as much as possible. Oh my god, skeleton, stop, stop. See, this is what I mean. You can't rush things. But I am, because doop-dee-doo-dee-doo, I am really hating this area. That's what, like, my 10th death in this episode? God, it drives me bonkers. But anyways, I guess this episode's gonna be part fails on having a nice guide for you guys. I do apologize. It's really troublesome for me, too. So let's hope I don't get knocked out by this. So, so never mind. That item in there was the only item to get. But now I have the skeleton stuck in that pit. So, yeah. Oh, I swear, if I can find where that necromancer is at, I will rip him a new one. But sadly, I don't know. Okay, so yeah, this is the area. Oh, no, you don't. Here you go, chopper hopper. So yeah, so we have that. Now we're back to the headless fella. And, oh boy, let's try this again. And, there is stays the way it came from. Yep, so if fire won't work, then I'll put lightning. Either that would help. Well, fire certainly does help a little bit. I'm not doing just 99E. So I'm fighting him save up some stamina and yeah, avoid that. And do a heavy and then light and then dodge. Ow, I just, wow, his whole body hurts when you do that. Okay. So when he does that jump, roll away from him. Like this. Otherwise your whole body will sting. And I'm dead. You know what? I'm gonna see if I, you know, see that right behind him is the gravestone. And alright guys, you know what, let's just head to the boss. I'm just gonna skim right through, show you the last two items besides the boss. I mean, besides that annoying flipping hairless guy, because again, I need at least a plus 10. This is a plus 5 claymore. Not the best level stats. Any weapon you use will barely scratch him unless you upgrade. So this game is heavily on, yo, upgrade your stuff. Like, I mean, it's like you guys really need to upgrade your weaponry. I was too sloppy to do that. Now this drop does not kill you, but you wanna drop here and avoid being pushed off by these falling skeletons. Now there is there an item here? No, there is not. There's only an item here. So you only gotta do this once. You just wanna carefully tiptoe off. And now we're back here. So we have the priest's hat, the holy items, traveling gloves, and a mace. So this is the clerk's stuff. Now, simple here, you just have to keep running and swiggle out of their way and into the boss area. So now they can't touch you. So yeah. Oh boy. Yeah, this should be easy, even with the weapon I have and my stats. And welcome to Pinwheel! Let's watch the cutscene, shall we? Now, I really hope I get the father mask. Okay, so he's the middle one. Don't ever forget that. Well, he will switch up. Basically, if you play Dark Souls 3, he's like the crystal. Like, they literally reuse the crystal sage as Pinwheel. So again, he just popped up. I'm being really reckless here because he's not that hard of a boss. It's just getting to him, as you saw, is the pain in the butt. Now we have the Rite of Kindling, a humanity and a homeward bone. Now the way out this through up here. Now, we don't have a teleportation, so, oh, right, I forgot to pick up the boss one. So, yay, the Mask of the Father. The Mask of the Father, which is what I wanted, helps equip loads, so... Because if you, read what it says, raises equipment load, and it's lighter, so, as you can see now, we're rolling pretty faster than we were. Not by much, because Havel's Ring is the best equip load, but, yeah. So, you could go that way to the bonfire. Yeah, but you had to go through the,
Hey, Wolfgang, what's up?
Halfway through the area.
Yeah, I went into a factory and there was a feral ghoul roaming in there.
Or you can go all the way back the way you came from. This is the shortcut around. I really wish there was a shortcut back to bonfire, but you want to grab this item. And pretty much this is the shortcut back. I'm not gonna use the shortcut. I am gonna use a homeward bone since we don't have the Lord Vessel, meaning we can't teleport from bonfire to bonfire. So I would go actually maybe show off the next area, but I can't do that. So you could just do whatever you want and get out of here. So, this only goes down, so your only path is to go up. So, again, this part is the hardest. A whole lot of people avoid it till they have the Lord Vessel. But I want the Rite of Kindling, because it gets really hard before you can get it. Now, this is basically much shortcut and shortcut. That's the shortcut drop, so you can just, if you survive the skeletons, and, you just get your way out. So, I'm just gonna show the video of me getting out. You can fight your way, you can, do whatever you like. But for me, I'm just speeding through because, again, if I kill them, they will actually stay dead now since I killed every last necromancer. But I just wanna get this over and done with. Move out of my way. Move out of my way. Thank you. All those exploding skulls just finished off all the enemies behind me. Almost all of them. And just keep running. Just keep running. Just keep running. Just keep on swimming. Just keep on swimming. Just keep on swimming. And you're still not safe yet. So you gotta just keep on running. Just keep on swimming. Just keep on power through it. I believe in you guys. You might die maybe once or twice. I got actually lucky there, and I was able to roll out of the three exploding skulls. The three skulls, I should say. And, there we are. If I did not die at all and managed to keep my souls, I would have had the, 30,000. But, you know what? I don't mind. I'm just gonna go into attunement real quick, and I'm gonna off screen. I'm gonna do some farming. Oh yeah, and here's the pyromancer we saved in the depths.
Oh, please, as always.
So yeah.
Goodbye. Peace.
So actually, pardon me. I'm gonna equip that pyromancer right now. This would have helped me a little while. So yeah, so this is it for the catacombs for now. We're not gonna go into the Tomb of Giants. That'll be after we get the Lord Vessel. and choose either Fremt or Karth. Or Karthi. I don't know. So, yeah. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it came useful somehow. Even though with all those deaths. I hope it somehow came useful. Maybe you guys learned from my mistakes. And don't do what I did. Get a divine weapon. You know, farm the poop slimes. And get green titanite shards. And make a divine weapon. And make that area easier for yourselves, because I certainly did not. So, see you guys in the next guide.